chilling and having a good, good time. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling or the windows in the rain is pouring. It will always be Christmas in my heart.
Hi, Glam Stars. I'm Maddie, and welcome to my channel if you have not yet became an official Glam Star. All that you have to do is hit that subscribe button in order to become one, and let's go ahead and get right into this video. So I posted a video recently on my body transformation, and in that video I of course briefly mentioned my waist training journey because that is what really contributed to my body being where it is on today. Through that video, a lot of people were curious about how I received such fantastic results. And they were looking for more information that they could use to speed up their waist training journey. So that's what I'm here to share with you all on today, and I hope that you definitely find this video helpful. Let's get into these tips and tricks that will speed up your waist training journey. Number one, listen to your body. The most important tip for successful waist training is remembering to listen to your body. Waist training is greatly personal depending on your body, so let yours tell you what works best and listen to what it needs. Following this one simple piece of advice will help you to reach your waist training goals a lot faster by ensuring that you enjoy waist training so that you can stick with it. While it works its magic over time, which is something that I like to mention when I make videos pertaining to the body, is it takes time. It's definitely a process to things, and a lot of people want instant results and instant gratification, and that is why they end up falling off of the bandwagon. I went to the gym for a week, I ain't seen nothing, so I ain't going back. That's pretty much how a lot of people work, and you have to learn to get rid of that mentality in order to see results with anything. Waist training is not just putting on a waist trainer and never putting it on again. You put it on for one day, no, you're not going to see results instantly, okay? Your body is not going to transform overnight. It's a process. It's a waist trainer getting to know your body. So definitely make sure that you're listening to your body, that you're knowing what your body needs. If your body say,
take this off,
most definitely do it. But definitely realize and understand that waist training is definitely a process. Number two, get your size right, okay? And this is a huge problem that we see a lot in the waist training community, is people getting waist trainers that don't even fit them. People getting waist trainers to squeeze in stuff that probably shouldn't even be squeezed in, okay? If you have too much going on in this region, you should definitely be getting a waist trainer to fit that area, okay? You should not be trying to get something that's way smaller than you, or that you can barely get into, or that you're about to overheat and faint from trying to put on, okay? So keep that in mind. Take your measurements before you go out and get a waist trainer. And plus, poor fitting waist trainers are extremely uncomfortable. And contrary to what you have heard, wearing a smaller waist trainer does not get your results any faster than anyone else, okay? You're just gonna be sitting there squeezing yourself in, about to fall out at any given moment. That's all that's gonna happen for you, okay? And pretty much the only thing that it is going to do is set you back. Because once you realize that your waist trainer does not fit, that you can't breathe in it, you're either gonna send it back and you're gonna have to get another one, and or you're gonna end up in the hospital because
you didn't squeeze in something that wasn't supposed to be squeezed in because you're trying to get a waist trainer that's too small for you.
So make sure that you get the right size, that way you won't be having any complications on your waist training journey. Number three, get a high quality waist trainer. I cannot stress this enough. I know that it is very easy to spend $20 on a waist trainer, or to get you a waist trainer from Walmart or from Rainbow or from wherever, but those aren't heavy duty waist trainers. You need something that has some grip to it, something that's gonna suck you right in, okay? So definitely invest some money into your shapewear. This waist trainer is my favorite one right now, and this is the Nude Shapes waist trainer. You can sleep in this waist trainer. You can work out in this waist trainer. I mean, it is great for so many different types of things. And let me tell you all, it's the most comfortable waist trainer that I've tried so far. I will have a link down below as to where you can purchase your very own, and please use my code, Maddie10, for 10% off of your purchase. But with that being said, this waist trainer is absolutely amazing, and it is only $40, okay? It cinches you right in, and it will give you that hourglass shape of your dreams. I've been using this waist trainer for a few months now, and let me tell you all, I am very impressed with it, and they are also the first brand to offer inclusion and to create different types of colors for each woman's skin tone. Definitely check out Nude Shapes if you haven't already heard of them. Anyways, now that I went on a rampage, let me finish what I was actually getting ready to say. Don't expect results from a lingerie or fashion waist trainer, okay? Those are made specifically for decoration. You know how you might have that formal living room in your house that nobody sits in, that nobody touches anything in? Think of these waist trainers as that type of thing, where it's pretty to look at. Fashion corsets are designed for look, not for training your waist to look a certain type of way, not for shaping you up and making you look curvaceous. Well, they might actually do that for the moment, but if you don't know, waist trainers have special boning in them that help to give you the body of your dreams, which those cheapy waist trainers from your local fashion store do not have. A flexible waist cincher is perfect for under that little black dress or for going to the gym, but it's definitely not for getting long-term waist training results. Season your waist trainer. Your waist trainer will need seasoning, breaking it in over the first few weeks in order for it to properly fit your body. Make sure that the first time that you put on your waist trainer that you are putting it on a hook that is comfortable to you. As you all can see, this one contains four, so right now I'm on this fourth hook, so it's time for me to buy another one. But what you do is you start at this first hook, then you move up and so forth and so on. So as your waist is getting smaller, you should be able to go over to that next hook on your waist trainer. Only wear your waist trainer for 1.5 to 2 hours within the first few weeks of receiving it. That way you can become comfortable with it and get to know your waist trainer a little bit, and in that same aspect is getting to know you as well. And we have waist train at a pace that is right for you. So just because you see somebody else wearing their waist trainer 10 hours a day, that might not be the proper thing for your body, which is why I recommend for all new waist trainees, I guess that's what I'd say, to start off slow. So that is why I recommend that 1.5 to 2 hours, and then you can work your way up once you start getting a little bit more comfortable. Because one thing about waist trainers is they are not meant to be comfortable. So when you first put them on, they are especially uncomfortable, okay? You really have to work your way up to that type of comfort. So once you become a little bit more comfortable, then you can increase the time that you have on your waist trainer. You can do 6 to 8 hours if you want to, and so forth and so on. And the last but not least thing that I have to say is track your process. Write down where you're starting at and write down where you want to be. Take pictures throughout your journey of waist training. That way you can see how far you've come. That way you can see how much weight you've lost off of your waist. And this is a way for you to keep up with your waist training journey and also to inspire you more to continue on this journey because of the results that you're seeing. And that is all of the information that I have on today about how to receive faster results when waist training. Like I said in the beginning of this video, please keep in mind that all of our bodies are different, so most definitely listen to yours, because your body definitely wants you to value its opinion and to listen to the fact that, hey, this might be a little bit uncomfortable for me. Hey, take this off before, you know, I give out on you. Definitely listen to your body. That is the most important thing in this whole entire video. And before I leave this video, I'm not gonna leave you all hanging. Let me share with you all my glam star of the day. I wanna thank you you so much for your sweet comment, and I thank you for consistently supporting me. And if you're looking to be featured in my next video, all that you have to do is leave a comment down below. Turn on your post notifications, because when I see that you're first to comment, that boosts your chances of being featured in my next video. And that is it for this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And if you don't have anything else to comment down below, please comment what you are, and that is a star. Always remember to keep glamming, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.